Today, officials from Idaho State University are reminding the public that they have got to be aware, you know, the next time you're at a party or any social situation. And this comes after a sexual assault was reported last week on campus.
Local News 8's Caitlin Nukitas joins us live from Pocatello to explain what happened. Caitlin.
Well, on Saturday, public safety received a report that a sexual assault happened right here in Turner Hall, and that was on October 4th. Now, the suspect was caught, but they say this is a good time to remind everyone you need to be safe.
In this situation, it wasn't somebody lurking on campus. There was a relationship there. We encourage all of our students, male and female, to make sure that when you're in those types of social settings, that you are taking those precautions.
ISU Director of Marketing and Communications, Adrian King, says on Saturday, public safety and the Pocatello Police Department were able to find the person accused of sexually assaulting a student in one of the dorm buildings. Both she and public safety director Steve Chatterton say sexual assault usually happens with someone the victim already knows.
The victim usually knows her attacker. They're acquainted, or it's a dating situation, and quite often alcohol is involved.
Chatterton says there are steps everyone can take to try and avoid ending up in this situation. Avoid being alone or isolated. Be aware of your surroundings. Know your limits, and watch out for friends.
And if you're at a party, keep an eye on your friends so that you help one another to stay safe.
King says this incident has already been dealt with, and students should not be afraid, just aware.
We don't view this as an ongoing security threat, but we do want you to be careful. And at the beginning of the school year is always a great opportunity for us to remind students of the things that they need to look out for.
Now, when this happened, students campus-wide received an email alerting them that this incident did in fact happen. But Chatterton says that if the students were in more imminent danger, they would receive a text message on their phone, which would alert them as to what's going on at the moment. Reporting live in Pocatello, I'm Caitlin Lukitas.
Thanks, Caitlin. King says the suspect does not live in Pocatello and has been banned from ISU property.
Time to check in with First